Bracchus Rex, king, sorcerer, and scholar, though not quite a gentleman.
The child has a small mirror in his hands. He holds it up at angles, inspecting his eyes, his chin, the crown of his head. He spots you, and his arms snap to his sides.
I'm not supposed to talk to lizards. What's a superior?
He shrugs and continues the game with a mirror, inspecting inside his nostrils.
Source? They told me I'm a sorcerer.
The child screws up his face and looks at you hard. He lifts his mirror up to his nose, closes one eye, and looks at himself again.
I don't see any source on you or me. I guess they're wrong or crazy. No one cares where I go. They know I can't leave the island. It's nicer out here than inside anyway. But you didn't die. I guess I am, but it's just normal to be scared. Nowhere isn't scary. There isn't anywhere safer. That's what I mean. You'll see.
Voidwoken. Those are the same beasts that sank our ship.
Damn!
They made it to the shore.
ready.
I thought these bloody collars were supposed to keep those things at bay. This pig's bladder was on the ship.
Look here, Quercus. Another giant. My word, this blasted isle is teeming with them.
What's that? Yes, I did see how it made short work of the great Acorn's servants. Quite right, very impressive.
But that is no reason to trust it. Giants like that destroyed our forests. They are the very reason the great Acorn is returning in all its wrath.
What? Dear me, have you taken leave of all six of your senses? You would have me use this giant for a shield? Why would I... Oh, I see. You cunning devil, Quercus. Of course, if it defeated the great Acorn's vile servants, it can do so again. We need only follow in its big, wide shadow and be safe.
Egad! It speaks our tongue, Quercus! Hush before!
What do you mean, a good time for introductions? You know full well who I am, you silly old cat. The great Solora, grandest of the... Oh, introduce myself to the giant! I shall do no such thing. You give away your trust too easily, my dear steed. No, we will have the giant march. In time, we'll see whether it deserves our confidence. Now, onwards! Shield! Venture forth, post haste. The great Acorn waits for no one.
junk.
This again. This again. A black cat. A herald of wisdom in my homeland. How fortuitous.
The cat's eyes are clouded and grey, but it stares at you with acute intensity.
What? How did I get... Hey, stop following me.
Me? I know who I am. At least I think I do.
Sometimes it feels like... No, I know who I am.
Who are you? You think books have the answer? No, I mean, I think I...
The cat shakes its head, as if trying to wake up from a deep sleep. The cat opens his mouth as if to speak, but his eyes lose focus, and with a jerk, he turns away from you. The cat's eyes are clouded and grey.
What's going on?
I've spotted something.
Here lies a nameless inmate. May he find the peace denied him in life in the Hall of Echoes.
One must put in due effort if one is to reap the proper reward.
Fading.
this again. A black cat. A herald of wisdom in my homeland. How fortuitous.
The cat's eyes are clear.
What?
Me? I know who I am.
Pedigree or Moggy. It doesn't matter. Not here. Not anymore.
The cat shakes its head, as if trying to wake up from a deep sleep.
Huh? Yeah. Fine. I'm fine. I'm not sure. It's all a little foggy.
The cat opens his mouth as if to speak, but his eyes lose...
I've spotted something. One must put in due effort if one is to reap the proper reward.
I'm ready.
Here lies a nameless inmate. May he find the peace denied him in life in the Hall of Echoes.
I wonder where this leads.
As the alcove opens up, you see the same skeleton that you met on the boat before it sank. He's still not wearing his mask. He's leaning over a corpse, prodding and pulling at the skin of its face. Bugger.
How on earth am I supposed to... Oh. Perhaps...
Skeletal fingers reach down and grip the skin of the dead man's face, pulling sharply upwards. After a few more tugs at the man's cheeks, the skeleton relents, letting the head drop to the ground with a damp thud.
Damnation! That stuck fast. I wonder, does the beard act as some form of anchor? Ah! No! Stay back! Don't... Oh, it's you. I must admit, I'm surprised. Perhaps you're more buoyant than I suspected. Oh, yes. An exceptionally common, but exceptionally valuable commodity. A face. A face that seems rather stubbornly attached to his skull. I would normally employ a tool to delicately, but viciously, rip the face from the body. I could then craft a mask to hide my bone. But as I lack such a tool...
The skeleton grabs the corpse by the cheeks and pulls hard, grunting in frustration as the body's skin holds firm.
Carved? Please. You hardly think I am one of your breed, do you? You have never seen anything like it because you have never met anyone like me. Simply put, I am an eternal, and you are not. You have my sympathies. Indeed. No one seems to have the good taste to be. My people are rather... absent. At least from this realm. As for the others... Well... There is an excavation site at the Black Pits oil fields. Perhaps there I'll find my answers. I suppose, circumstances being what they are, it could be... advantageous. You seem more at ease in this world than I. A guide would certainly be useful. Excellent. While we are conversing, perhaps you notice that I am rather skilled in, well, all things. Of course, the arcane arts are my little speciality, but being a brilliant wizard does not mean I cannot handle blade or bow. So, which do you require for this enterprise of yours? Someone with a little muscle. Really? I am adept as any in the fine art of hitting people with sticks. But what exactly are you looking for? If I had your mind, I'd rather wish I could change it too. But very well. Do take your time.
I could do that with one hand behind my spine. Now, shall we get on? There is rather a lot to see.
Splendid. Very well. Let's be off.
What's this? I found something. I need a shovel.
I am not opposed to manual labor if circumstances require.
Thank you.
One, two, long dead are the crew. Three, four, pretty shells on the shore. Hey, mister. It's a lot nicer here than that stinking boat, huh? I'm sure glad you went back to save the others. Saw one of them wringing out their tunic at the shore a few hours ago. Say hi for me. One, two, long dead are the crew. Three, four, pretty shells on the shore.
Boring.
Now speak.
I am a proud loyal to the Order. I would not dream of subverting our cause.
Atusa, please.
Your Godwoken has asked you a question. Answer him.
Need I repeat myself?
But I know nothing of any Verdus.
We already know the truth, Magister. Now speak.
I am a proud loyal to the Order. I would not dream of subverting our cause.
Atusa, please.
Your Godwoken has asked you a question. Answer.
This again.
We already know the truth, Magister. Now speak. Answer him.
Need I repeat myself?
But I know nothing of any Verdus.
We already know the truth, Magister. Now speak.
I am a proud loyal to the Order. I would not dream of subverting our cause.
Atusa, please.
Your Godwoken has asked you a question. Stay back, sorcerer, and stay silent. Our Godwoken speaks.
We know you've been helping sorcerers escape, Atusa. We have proof.
I'd sooner cut my tongue out than lie to you, Alexander. I know nothing of any escapees.
If you can tell the Godwoken no more, your tongue is of no use. Cut it out.
This can't be serious, Alexander. Come!
You should know by now to obey your superior, Magister, whatever she may ask.
Thank you.
Natusa pinches the tip of her tongue with two fingers and brings her dagger to its root. Her eyes squeeze shut. Drops of blood form against the dagger's edge and quickly fall to the ground. She groans.
Stop! My father, may his soul rest in peace, would be disappointed in you, Atusa. To think you would lie to his only son, your bishop, and your friend these many years. The fate of our realm hangs in the balance. If you will not help us save it, then you will help the Void destroy it. Dallas?
Yes, Your Holiness?
I believe we're done here.
What a waste. Come, we'll be needed elsewhere.
The Lizard Magister, or what's left of her, lies in a puddle of gore.
These creatures are so prone to violence, naturally, the weaker specimens suffer.
I told him at noon exactly, didn't I?
She's gone. Gone.
Where is he?
Vara, she ain't coming back.
Come on, old man. I can't wait all day.